Now, what about that pageant that had Bert and Ernie in it?
Oh, that was the milk pageant.
Oh, yes. That was so great, wasn't it?
I love that.
I love that one.
And when Harry Monster came up.
Hey, Snuffy.
Hey,
hi, Selena. Hi. Oh, hi. Oh. Welcome to Sesame Street. Today we're going to talk about the letter U. There. And the number 7.
And guess what? Prairie Dawn is putting on another pageant, and we're all gonna be in it.
Oh, boy.
That's right. See, Prairie puts on these really great shows, and she calls them pageants.
Yeah.
She writes the story, and everybody gets to play a part.
Gee, I wonder what part I'm gonna play.
Yeah, me too. I wonder if I'm gonna have a big part.
Oh, Snuffy, whatever part you have to play, it's going to be a big part.
Oh, yeah, I get it. A big part.
Oh, yeah. A big part. That's funny.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, Prairie is never late. I wonder where she could be.
Don't try to talk with a thermometer in your mouth.
Prairie Dawn slept over last night, but when she woke up, she didn't feel too well.
I'm sorry, Prairie, just one more minute. Okay, let's check to see if you have a temperature.
This is terrible.
Thermometer says you have a slight fever.
Oh, no.
You're sick, Prairie. You're going to have to stay inside for a while.
Yeah, and Gabby, you're going to have to stay away from Prairie until she feels better. Otherwise, you might catch her cold.
Okay, Mommy. I hope you feel better soon, Prairie. If you can't go out, then I guess there won't be any pageant until you get better.
Oh, no pageant! Oh, but there has to be a pageant. I promised everybody.
Prairie, listen, you're sick. You're going to have to stay in bed for a while. Everyone will understand if there's no pageant.
Oh, but I really want there to be a pageant. I mean, even if I can't go out, maybe I can still write the story and the music and think of the costumes to wear.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, but the trouble is, I have been coughing and sneezing so much that I cannot think of one idea of what the pageant should be.
Well, Prairie, in the meanwhile, we have to take care of you until you feel better. Now, here is something that's good for you when you have a cold.
Oh, orange juice?
Yes, it's good to drink lots of liquids when you have a cold, especially juices.
Oh, yes. I need orange juice, and I need an idea for my pageant.
Well, think of it this way. You'll drink the orange juice. It'll help your cold. You'll feel a lot better, and then maybe you'll have a great idea for your pageant.
Yeah, maybe I will.
Here's a straw. Good girl.
Any ideas?
No. It tasted good, but it didn't give me an idea for a pageant, and I need an idea soon.
Salud. Oh. You know, it takes a while to get rid of a cold, Prairie. Look, why don't you blow your nose?
Oh.
Might make you feel better.
Will it make me feel good enough to get an idea for my pageant?
Well, I don't know about that, but you'll definitely feel better. Blow your nose.
Here you go. Here. Oh, good girl. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, thanks. My nose isn't as stuffy anymore.
Any ideas?
No. I still do not have an idea for my pageant.
Well, there's one more thing I want you to do, Prairie.
Huh?
When you have a cold, it's very important to get a lot of rest. And I think it would be a good idea if you took a little nap.
Oh. A nap?
Yeah. Well, maybe after you're rested, you'll think of a great idea for your pageant. Mm. Will you give it a try?
All right. Maybe if my brain takes a nap, it will be rested enough to think of a good idea for my pageant.
Mm. Oh,
thanks for the orange juice and the tissue and the nap idea. You're really such good friends.
Oh, you're welcome, Prairie.
We hope you feel better, Prairie.
Have a good nap, Prairie.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, Prairie, you have a nice, restful nap. There you are.
Thanks.
Okay.
Okay. That's good. Oh, I just hope I wake up with a good idea.
How you doing, Prairie? You feeling better? Did you have a nice nap?
Yes, thank you, Maria.
Oh, good.
Actually, I do feel a little bit better. Now, if I could only get an idea from my pageant, maybe I'd be well enough to put it on.
I don't think so, Prairie. I think that when you're sick, you should try and do things that take a little less energy than putting on a pageant. Oh. Well, I have something here that's a good thing to do when you're sick. How about if I read this book to you?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
It's called The Maestro Plays by Bill Martin Jr. Pictures by Vladimir Radunsky.
Oh, well, that sounds like an excellent book. Okay. Hey, maybe it will give me an idea for something to write my pageant about.
Maybe.
Oh.
Okay, let's read.
Yeah.
The Maestro Plays. He plays.
Oh, thanks, Maria. That was a very nice book. But it did not give me an idea for my pageant.
Oh, I'm sorry, Prairie. I know how you feel. I mean, what kind of a pageant can a person write when all that's around are thermometers and tissues and juice and books and coughs and sneezes?
Wait a minute! Maria, what did you just say?
I said, what kind of a pageant can a person write when all that's around are thermometers and tissues and juice and books and coughs and sneezes?
Yes, Maria, that is it.
It is?
Yes, you just gave me the perfect idea for my pageant. Oh, Maria, please bring me some paper and a pencil. It is time to write my pageant.
All right, a paper and a pencil coming right up.
Yes, please.
Wait, you mean even though Prairie is sick and can't be here, she wants us to put on the pageant anyway?
That's right, Zoe.
And she wrote down all the words and music right here on these pages. And there's a part for everybody. For you and Snuffy and Miles.
But wait a minute, Selena. There's something very important that's missing. Prairie. She always plays the piano in her pageant. If she's not here, who's gonna play the piano?
That's right. We've never done it without Prairie.
No, never.
Wait a minute. That's why Bob is here. Bob can play the piano.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, yeah, I'd be glad to do it. I hope I can help save the day.
All right.
Wait a minute.
Thanks, Bob.
I think we have another problem.
Yeah?
Well, Bob can take Prairie's place playing the piano. Okay. But Prairie always says lots of important words in the pageant. Who's going to say Prairie's words?
Well, Zoe, I guess if I can play piano for Prairie, I can probably say her words, too.
Great! Yeah, that's a great idea.
Right. But Bob?
Yes?
You're not Prairie.
That's true.
Well, you don't look like Prairie.
No.
Prairie's got cute blonde hair.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't sound like Prairie.
No, I certainly don't.
No. So how can you be Prairie?
That's right, Bob. You don't look like Prairie at all. Okay, now everybody.
Don't worry. I have an idea.
What?
It'll fix everything.
What?
Come with me, Bob.
What? Where are we going?
Don't worry about a thing. Okay, everybody, get ready for the pageant.
What do you have in mind?
What do you think she's gonna do with Bob?
Selena, are you sure you want me to go through with this?
Absolutely. This one is for Prairie Dawn.
All right, just for Prairie
Dawn. Now hit it.
Grown-ups and children, dear friends, young and old. This pageant is all about having a cold. Please listen closely, as this pageant will tell of a child with a cold and how he got well, well.
I woke up one morning, my alarm clock went off. My nose had a sniffle. My throat had a cough. I'd been sneezing quite hard, if the story be told. And I said to myself, Snuffy, you've caught a cold.
He said to himself, Snuffy, you've got a cold. He felt pretty awful. Oh, what should he do? He feared that he had a high temperature, too.
My nose is quite stuffy. I don't feel so well. Do I have a fever? Now, how can I tell? Oh, look who is coming. Look who's walking by. It's a friendly thermometer, come to say hi.
'Twas a friendly thermometer, come to say hi.
Hi, I'm a thermometer, clever and wise. I let people know when their temperatures rise. If the number I point to is above 99, you know that your temperature's not very fine.
Hello there, thermometer. How we need you. I'm Snuffy's mommy. May I please read you? Oh, Snuffy, my dearest, the news is not fun. Your temperature now is 101.
His temperature now was 101.
There are things you must do now to feel at your best. Drink plenty of liquids and get lots of rest. Oh, look who is coming. Is that who I think? Yes, it's one of those liquids that you ought to drink.
I am a cup of cool orange juice. Drink plenty of me, you'll feel strong as a moose.
Now here is some juice in your own little cup. Please be a good boy and drink all of it up.
He drank all his juice and then when he was done, what could he do for some sneezy time fun?
Oh, look, 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 look! Look who's coming, it's true! It's just what you wanted, a new picture book!
Hello, little fellow, I'm here if you need me. If you've got a cold with your mom, you can read me.
Oh, thank you, dear book. I will read right away to my sick, sneezy son on this sad, sneezy day.
For 3 days, the young fellow lay in his bed with a cold in his nose and a real stuffy head. He read and he rested, drank juice all the while, till his mom took his temperature and smiled a big smile.
Oh, son, my dear son, I am happy to say your temperature's normal. Now you can
Oh, Mom, I am so glad. I feel light as a breeze. I'm totally well now, except for one last big sneeze.
He was totally well, except for one last big sneeze.
Thanks, Mom. Thanks, thermometer, juice, and book two. And now here's my last sneeze. Sorry, everybody. I didn't mean to sneeze so hard. Are you okay?
Yeah.
That's the end of my pageant, so everyone, please. Get up off the floor. Please get up off your knees. And please, all you actors, please take a big bow. Our cold pageant was fantastic, but it's all over now.
Good time, actually.
It was, yeah.
Everybody...
Oh, the pageant was so great, Prairie. You would have loved it.
Mm.
Especially Bob. He did a great job taking your place.
Oh, well. Oh yeah, Bob.
He did. He talked like you. He even looked like you.
Oh, no, it wasn't.
Really, Bob? Well, can you show me?
Yeah. Oh, well, no.
I want to see too, Bob.
No, that wasn't the pageant. This would be, I'm a little, that'd be silly
like
to do it.
No,
I want to
see. Really? I don't know. You sure?
Yeah.
All right. Let's see. It went like,
grown-ups and children, dear friends, young and old, this pageant is all about having a cold.
Very good, Bob.
Oh,
very good.
Oh,
yeah.
Now it's it was fun.
But how did you look like me, Bob?
Oh, well, they...
Come on,
they...
Bob, put it on.
No, I'm not. We did it. We've been there. We've
do
done that.
Yes.
No, are you... Oh, come on. You're going to make me
it.
Do this?
I want to see it. Please.
Oh, all right. All right.
Like
just for you, Prairie.
This is great.
There. I mean, this is silly, isn't
not
it?
Bad. Not a bad likeness, actually.
Oh,
boy, Bob, you sure look a lot like her.
Oh, thanks a lot for nothing. Yeah, I appreciate that.
Bob, would you do a little bit more of the pageant for me? Oh. I'm sure it would make me feel a lot better.
Well,
yeah,
it's really silly. More?
Yeah.
All right. Just for you, Prairie. Let's see.
Thank you.
Please listen closely as this pageant will tell of a child with a cold and how he got well.
Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter U and by the number 7. Bye-bye.
Coming soon on Sesame Street.
That it's not important what tuba players can do for triangle lovers or what triangle lovers can do for tuba players. What's important is what they can do for each other.
Yeah.
Yes, and that is they can be friends and be together just like their hats. Now let's play a little music.
Toodaloo.
For Sesame Street is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by public television stations and their contributors.